Hi, I'm Jeff Strong. I'm creator of the Auditory Brain Stimulation Therapy Rhythmic Entrainment Intervention. In a lot of my videos, I talk about calm and focus. I talk about how I can use drumming to help kind of activate your brain and help you be able to focus on tasks, to improve your cognition and sometimes your executive function. And I talk about sensory processing and other areas. And it's all really centered on what I do with REI or Brain Shift Radio, really any of my music where I'm playing. But there's other aspects to helping focus that I wanted to talk about in this video. Years ago, I wrote a book called ADHD for Dummies, and my co-author and I, Michael Flanagan, were looking at techniques that people with ADHD could do. Part of the book was about, you know, different therapies that were out there, the prevalence of ADHD, the characteristics, but as well, we wanted to cover strategies. We wanted to cover things you could do that can help with your focus, that don't require any kind of intervention. Now, I'm a big fan of listening to my music because it does help a lot. But these other things are really important, and they're the day-to-day things that I do that I found over the years have had the biggest impact. And Dr. Flanagan and I, researching our book, found had the biggest impact for most people. And there's basically five different things that I recommend that you do to help with your focus, especially if you have ADHD like I do. First of all, the number one thing to be doing is to get your body moving, exercise. And I'm a big fan of doing exercises that really gets your metabolism going. That helps me focus. So I like anything that's going to push me a little bit. I like interval training. Because it's high intensity for short periods of time. You take little breaks. I'm not a real fan of long aerobic exercise because I think that puts us in a different zone. It doesn't really put us in a zone of clarity. It puts us almost in an altered state of consciousness. I used to be a runner, and when I would run long runs, I'd get into this spacey place that was kind of just like in between worlds. And it was a really fun place to be, and you could kind of run forever and just kind of chug along, but it didn't help me focus. What helps me focus is doing high-intensity, short exercises. And so my workouts nowadays, first thing I do in the morning when I get up after I have my coffee, is I'll drink some water, and then I'll do 15 or 20 minutes of high-intensity workout, and there'll be short intervals. Maybe 30 seconds of work and 15 seconds of a break or any variation that I do around that. But the idea is you need to exercise. You need to exercise every day. And it doesn't have to be intense like this. You could just go on a walk. The idea is that you get your body moving. That's going to help with your focus. It really makes a difference. So if you're sitting at your desk and you're finding yourself just fading and not being able to focus, get up and move around. Or if you feel like it, do some push-ups or some squats or something. Anything to get your metabolism moving, get your brain moving, get the blood flowing into your brain, because that's really the key here. Got to get the blood flowing into the brain. The second thing that you need to do that has one of the biggest impacts, I think exercise has the most. I think the second is hydration. You have to have enough water in your system to be able to get your brain going. Your brain needs water. Your whole body needs water, but especially just getting hydrated helps the blood flow through your brain and, again, helps you stay more focused. So definitely drink a lot. I live in the desert. I drink about a gallon a day, and I drink water, and that's really important. Water with a squeeze of lime or lemon in it is a great way to go. Avoid anything with caffeine, anything with sugars in it. Juices or sodas or anything like that with sugar in it of any kind is going to be worse. Which leads to the third thing that is really important, diet. And this is the hardest thing for most people, by the way, because the best diet for people who have attention issues is a whole food diet that doesn't have any processed foods. So you don't want any processed sugars, you don't want any processed additives, preservatives, or colorings. And there's kind of two schools in this thought. One is to go with a low glycemic index whole food diet. Another is to go with the fine gold diet. You can look that up, fine gold. Fine gold diet is basically the idea of eliminating anything with additives, preservatives, or colorings. And so you're basically looking, and the biggest culprit for that, and the reason the fine gold diet, in my mind, was developed was a lot of kids were getting food that had coloring in it, and you could just see almost immediately their behavior changed with the food coloring. And but I'm looking at the sugars that are the problem for me. And this took me years and years to figure out. And for me, if I can avoid the processed foods or anything that processes like sugar in my body, so flours and sugars, processed foods, really dangerous for me, and this is true with a lot of people with ADHD, is that the higher glycemic index foods make me foggy. It makes me unclear, makes me tired. You know, may I get an initial boost from it. That'll be energy boost, but it won't be a focus boost. And then I'll just be lethargic, and I won't be able to focus at all. As a matter of fact, if I have too much sugar-type substance, and that could even be white rice, it could be pizza because of the crust, I could be foggy for days. I just recently went through a two-week period where I just could not focus, and I realized it was because I was eating some processed foods. And I'd gotten to a point where there was enough in my system that I was just foggy. And then I had to spend a bunch of time cleaning up my diet and focusing on lean proteins and vegetables and limiting even my fruit for a while. And then all of a sudden I'm able to focus again. So diet, take a look at that. Make sure that you're eating a clean diet of unprocessed foods. Stay away from the flour and the sugar and you'll be good. The fourth thing is meditation. And I know this is really hard for people with ADHD. Being able to meditate is, when I first was introduced to mindful meditation, I wanted to scream. It was just horrible to be able to have to sit down and clear the thoughts out of my mind. I mean, that was just the most ridiculous thing in the world for somebody like me who his mind is going a mile a minute. So what kind of meditation do I recommend? I believe in an active mind meditation. And I have some videos on this where we're using the drumming, the music to help bring the brain into this low theta state of consciousness. Meditation, people who are really adept at meditation, who've been spending a lot of time meditating, they get into this lower state of the theta state of consciousness. Now, theta exists between about 4 and 8 cycles per second, 4 and 8 hertz. Adept meditators will actually go down to about 4 hertz, sometimes even a little slower, down into the delta state of consciousness. This is a great state to be in. This is a great exercise to be doing, but for somebody with attention issues, doing it without the support of the drumming is really difficult. And that doesn't mean you need to buy my music in order to do this. Pick up a drum and just tap a 4-beat-per-second rhythm. This is a really simple way to do it. If you do that, and it doesn't have to be, heck, it doesn't even have to be a drum. You can use a hardcover book. Just repeated rhythm at 4 beats per second. You can even use your thumb. You can use a box, you can use a pan, you can use anything that has a little bit of resonance to it. Tap out a 4-beat-per-second rhythm. If you're doing that for yourself, it's a great way to meditate. And then just sit down and just allow your mind to go where it's going to go. If a thought comes in, who cares? Try not to dwell on it. Just focus on the drumming. If you're not interested in playing the drum, I have a few videos that have an active mind meditation. I do it a little differently for people who are listening, because the repetitive rhythm can be a problem for somebody with ADHD. It's better to vary the rhythm a little bit. And I talk about this in the videos that I have on that. The idea here is I take the 4-beat-per-second pulse and I'll change it up a little bit. And so it might be like this. The idea is to create an unpredictable but consistent pattern. So the underlying pulse is always the same, about 4 beats per second, but the accent patterns, the bass tones, the open tone accents, they are unpredictable and they're varying. That brings the brain into the same state, but allows the ADD brain, the inattentive brain, something to chew on, something to be able to hold on to keep it somewhat engaged without overriding our consciousness. And that's the idea. So Meditation is really important. You don't have to sit and breathe and focusing on clearing your mind and be mindful. That's maddening for somebody with ADHD. Use a support mechanism. Either listen to one of my videos or pick up a drum-like substance and play a 4-beat-per-second pulse. This is what I would recommend. And then the last thing you need to do as somebody with attention issues, you need to learn how to make lists and you need to learn how to prioritize. Now, I have a system that I do that a lot of the high-performance people kind of use anyway. And this, for me, as somebody with attention issues and executive function issues. Now, executive function is part of what goes wrong, basically, with somebody who has ADHD. And executive function is the ability to kind of prioritize, to be able to make decisions, to be able to see a sequence of things, to be able to plan. A lot of people with ADHD are very impulsive. We tend to just do what's on our mind and not really think about the consequences, but also not be able to think about how it fits into the larger scope of how to accomplish a goal. And so for me, this pattern is really important. And what I do is this. Before I leave the office every day, I write down the 5 things that I need to do tomorrow. So I'll write down those 5 things that I need to do. And it takes me a minute sometimes to think about, because I have a huge list, like everybody does, right? And I need to figure out what's important. And so first of all, I need to learn how to prioritize. I need to decide, okay, now these are important things to do, those not so much. And so I'll pick 5 things that are the most important things that I need to do the next morning. I'll write them down. And I'll email them to myself, because that's the way I do it. A lot of people say you should write it down freehand because it does something. Physical act of writing somehow makes some connections. I'm not really sure. I like to email it to myself. So to do tomorrow, send an email with these 5 things on it. First thing I do in the morning is I look at that list. I'll either open the email, and no other emails, by the way, or I'll have the email printed out and put on my desk. I will tackle those 5 things before I do anything else, before I even think about doing anything else. I don't give myself the luxury of saying, are these 5 things important? I decided yesterday they were, so they are. I just mindlessly do them, focus in and I do them. And then once a week, I take a look at my week and try to plan it out. This, for somebody with ADHD, is really hard to be able to sit down and look at your week ahead and say, okay, now this is the plan I have for the week. It's really hard to prioritize it like that. It's hard to set the steps in place. So I've got a long-term project and I want to get from here to there, and there's 5 steps in between. It's hard sometimes to figure out what those 5 steps are. So maybe you determine the 1 step you need to do this week. So if you have a big project, just choose 1 step that you need to do. And then just don't get overwhelmed with it. Don't set too much for yourself. This is the biggest thing that people with ADHD get into when they're trying to make a list and prioritize. They put too much stuff on the list. The hardest thing for you to do is to be able to decide something is not important and put it aside. So that's the number one skill you're going to need to learn when you're developing your 5 items for each day and then looking at your long-term week. So these 5 things are really important to do. For your attention, like I said, it's getting some good movement, some good exercise, hydrating, eating non-processed foods, staying away from the flour and the sugar, meditating, and setting lists and goals and prioritizing. So if you do these 5 things and then you listen to my music as well, you're good to go. So if you have any questions, as always, contact us at contact@stronginstitute.com or call us at 800-659-6644.